Yeah. Woof, woof, woof.
This isn't looking good.
Don't let them past us! Got you right where I want you!
Outsiders! Blast them!
Away, beast. We have pressing business here.
Oneril, I believe this beast has come to petition the council.
That creature? Fey law does not apply to such as they.
You realize we make the laws. Step up to the podium, petitioner. I, at least, am curious what you have to say.
Hail, stranger. I am Savan, speaker of the One True King's Council. State your nature and business for the record, please.
Your nature, yes. What are you exactly? You're not one of the... well, what do they call themselves? The Dran, are you? Neither Fey nor Dran. How very curious. Tell us more about this Earth.
Oh, Nael, you waste our time. The Fey have more imperative matters that require our attention.
Onaril speaks true. Please, petitioner, briefly state your business before the council.
Oh, you see, it wastes our time.
A pity. I had hoped for more stimulating distraction.
If that is all you have to say, petitioner, then please step aside. We have quite enough troubles to occupy our time.
You have wasted quite enough of our time, foreigner. The Fey have far more important concerns than you before us.
Hold a moment, Onaril. Perhaps this stranger could be of use to us. The Fey presently live in fear and uncertainty, stranger. The One True King has been usurped by an imposter, aided by one of those seated before you, but we know not which. As an independent party, you might find clarity where we have failed. Will you help us?
That is wise. You are under no commitment unless and until you choose to make an accusation. That said, should you come across sufficient evidence, you are permitted, within certain conditions, to accuse one of those seated here, and this body will consider the accusation.
A great tragedy, stranger. For eons, the Fey and this council have faithfully served the One True King. But alas, his rule has been curtailed.
The imposter, Faelin or Faerun or whatever they call themselves now, placed the king in an eternal slumber from which he cannot be woken.
The king was attacked in his own chambers, behind this very door. The imposter could not have entered without aid from a member of this council.
But, of course, we all have our alibis, as you can imagine. None of us were here. This has been proven many times.
If you can find any evidence tying one of us to this tragedy or to the imposter, then Fey justice might be done.
It won't be enough, Savan. The imposter still sits upon the throne.
Yet, it will be a step, and a necessary one, toward restoring order among the Fey.
It means you're not Fey, and your life is easily forfeit.
Please, Onaril. Stranger, we will discuss the conditions of your accusation if and when you choose to make one.
do not. This fast does nothing.
Peace, Oneril. The law is clear on this point, as you well know.
I will answer your question, stranger. With a traitor among us, trust has shattered. If any of us were to produce evidence at this stage, it would be suspect by all.
And rightly so. Either of you would love any excuse to remove me from the Council.
And you do not wish to hold half the Council's power yourself, Oneril? You cannot pretend it isn't true.
Regardless, stranger, you are not from this world, either of these worlds. So, any evidence you bring would be free from the suspicions which we have cast upon ourselves. We now know that the imposter approached each one of us at some point, whispering promises of freedom and power, trying to poison our minds against the one true king.
He only said what we wanted to hear. Pity one of us listened.
Can you blame them, though? The imposter called out important truths.
Is that an admission of guilt, Niel?
If you would allow me to finish. I was saying he called out important truths that we must take to heart, despite the poison that obviously accompanied them. We would do well to address the flaws raised by the imposter. And I find it difficult to cast blame on any who thought there might be a smoother path towards doing so.
And yet that path has led to ruin. We have merely exchanged one tyrant for another.
Indeed, but our feelings on the outcome are irrelevant. This council must be absolved of guilt if we are ever to restore order to the Fae. Alas, we do not know.
There is no blood, no wound that we can see.
Not that we were able to investigate the scene fully.
At your request, Oneril. I cannot trust either of you backstabbers nor anyone you might call to serve us. Were those not your words?
They were indeed, and the sentiment holds.
Regardless, it is unknown even what could harm the king. For it is said that no mortal weapon can kill him.
And many have tried.
The king has ruled over the Fae as long as anyone can recall. He has always been a guiding force, both in our world and our lives.
Some believed he was too much of a guiding force.
More than some. Yet, look at us now. The king sleeps, and our world is spun into chaos.
Indeed. Would seem his life is more entwined with our wealth than anyone knew.
Imagine what would have happened if he had been killed. precisely my point. This foreigner may have any number of reasons for accusing any one of us.
Which is why, if and when evidence is produced, we alone will pronounce the final judgment.
And if that evidence has been falsified, tainted, how do I know one of you has not paid this interloper to act on your behalf?
Onuriel, only you assume that everyone is as unscrupulous as yourself. Not everyone seeks power at any cost.
Very well. I will judge it when I see it. I trust no one. But I trust the two of you less than this foreigner. course! How could we have been so blind? The genius of this foreigner, who is so much more clever than all of the Fae together.
Please, Onoriel. Their question is academic curiosity. The simple answer, stranger, is magic of a kind more powerful than any here have yet seen. We suspect the imposter's conspiracy went even deeper than this council alone.
All the more reason to identify the conspirator among us.
They are a monster. They care nothing for the welfare of the Fae.
Nor those of us who serve the Fae.
Nor for the law. On this we all agree. The imposter's plan should never have been carried out. So it would seem.
We cannot function like this, stranger. If we cannot root out the traitor, then this council remains impotent.
As you will, stranger. Should you find evidence, though, bring it before us.
All right, let's do this.
Yeah.
Here they come.
Damn it.
All right. Thank you.
Here they come.
return. I trust you have purpose here. As you will, stranger. Should you find evidence, though, bring it.
The strange one returned. Indeed, I sensed as much. For she was a sister to me. Such was our bond. I take no pleasure in this, but you have taken bold steps toward easing the suffering of this world. I thank you. And I hope, too, that you may find what you seek. Gracing me with your... Nami! Gracing me... As do... The one true king rules this kingdom with an iron fist, mollifying his subjects with promises of freedom and prosperity. And to be sure, there was prosperity for some. Those who did not offer praise and fealty, who did not share in the royal values, who were deemed unworthy in myriad ways, their prosperity was taken and given to the favored. It was freedom for some at a cost to many, and eventually there were some who sought to plot against him. And so, one tyrant was replaced with another. The one true king was inviolate, but the impostor called upon a dark magic. And thus were two kingdoms twined, and thus chaos surrounding. Before his deposition, there were those who believed it foolishness to oppose the one true king. That our very world relied upon his rule. This turned out to be true. I saw it myself at the end. In the final seconds before our kingdoms collided, the twining was not mere coincidence, nor punishment. It was an inevitable consequence. Two worlds ruined by the hubris of the one. Alas, that I did not see it sooner. It is amusing that you think I owe you anything at all, strange one. I have told you all that I wish to, just as you have told me all that you wish to reveal about yourself. Certainly, strange one. Indeed, I take my thank you.
Nightweaver?
Nightweaver?
You're back? Or am I dreaming? Sure.
Don't
tell him I sent you, Lino.
Run! Kill the trespassers!
Glad that's over.
She was the only one who understood me.
Traveler. I knew you'd stay.
Goodbye, Traveler.
Open link.
Yeah. Yeah. Watch your back. Can't know who to trust out there.
Open link.
You want my permission, stranger? You're gonna have to prove your worth. I need you to kill the mayor. Oh, damn, stranger. You would have made one hell of a mud dog. I'm just pulling you again here. I don't want nobody dead. And the firing range is yours anytime you like. Don't need no one's permission. All right. I guess I set myself up for that one. I told you the mud dogs didn't take hell from no one. And weren't anyone stood up to us without getting knocked down. Save one. This mutter walks into my court, confident as a wolf in a rabbit trap. I'm thinking, this'll be a fight to remember, eh? At best. Then, I noticed something the mutter's got on him. It's a watch. What belonged to my old man. I figure he finally tripped the branches and I'm about to wring this wanderer's neck myself. But then, the wanderer says the old man gave it to him. That caught me. The old man wouldn't give up that watch to no one but family. And he never gave it to me. I let the wanderer go. After taking the watch, of course. But I couldn't stop thinking about it. Sometime later, I got the nerve to see the old man myself. He surprised me. He wasn't pissed or patronizing. Just sat me down and started telling stories like we'd been chatting every day. He didn't say nothing about the watch when I told him. Just glad it had a home. Tell you what, I think he wanted me to take it, the old bastard. Anyway, we talked a lot after that, and when word got out that folks here at the ward were starting something new, well, the old man and I both knew what needed doing. I told the mud dogs they were free to do as they liked. We weren't a pack no more. And the old man and I set up shop here. Kind of boring to tell you the truth, but better than a bullet hole, I guess. Oh, that old mutter. People call him Mudtooth. He's set up over yonder, and he's more than happy to tell you about himself. And then some. You wouldn't know it to look at him, but he was the leader of the Mud Dogs before I took him over. They'd got soft, see? Couldn't hack it in a dog-eat-dog world. Of course, that ain't the way he tells it. We still don't see eye to eye on which of us was right. Disagree to agree, I guess. Don't know what else I can tell you, save the stories folks around here like to spin. The way they tell it, that wanderer walked through crystals to other worlds until one day they slammed the door on the Deadwood altogether and saved the world. Yeah, they all sound just like my old man with these stories. Who says they have? Deadwood is still here, ain't they? Maybe the bulk of them have just moved on or something. I don't know. I ain't complaining, mind you. There's definitely something different about this place. Maybe if I stick around long enough, I'll figure out what it is. Well, the Mud Dogs ran for years. Started out with my old man in a place called Sanctuary, and eventually came out of here. We set ourselves up in a place folks started calling Cutthroat Channel. Nobody came in or out without our say-so. Not even Deadwood. Yeah, I got a story or two from the glory days. I ain't my old man. He'll talk your ear off and then use it as a chew toy. But at least I'll tell you the truth. That's so. Well, it was a bad winter. Real bad. Even the Deadwood wouldn't go out in it. But they didn't need to. Goddamn Earth was killing us all on its own. There was nothing to eat, and I mean nothing. Mud Dogs, we raid and steal, but there weren't no one to raid from. We threatened people's lives, and they'd laugh like it was a gift. Weren't surprising then when the dogs turned on each other. Started with one fool called Beers. He accused me of hoarding, so I punched him. Soon the whole gang was fighting.
It was chaos. Bleeding and shouting and cussing. Finally, they crack beers on the skull, and he don't get up. Quiet, I shout. And when I got their attention, I say, plenty to eat now. It's over 100 pounds of meat on your average human stranger. Win it like that? It'd be stupid to pass it up. What? You think dog eat dog was some kind of metaphor? All right. There's one of my old man's tales that is true. He used to live in this old chopper. Made a good sniper's nest, letting him pop off deadwood one at a time. That kept him off for a while. But the mud dogs got wind they were mustering something big. I weren't about to let the old man kick it, so we set a trap up for their trap. Problem was, they moved faster than we thought. We had explosives set around for most of the area. Deadwood came too soon. We hadn't set the detonators yet. The old man, though, he wakes in the crack of night, howling, popping off shot after shot at the root. Well, one of his shots must have hit our explosives, because suddenly, the whole street goes up in flames. My dogs got lucky. Only a couple were close enough to get singed. But the root got blown all to hell. To this day, my old man thinks he killed 300 of them, all by himself. Of course I did. Can't have the old murderer thinking he's God's gift to this gray earth. He don't ever stop telling the tale his way, though. You ever hear of the Root Mother? Ah, she's one of them weirdos, even the Deadwood left alone. Folks used to see her for advice. Crazy folks, desperate. My mud dog's caught one of these crazies. As he begs for his life, he tells us some secret the Root Mother told him. A place in the sewer, good to hole up against Deadwood. Dumb bastard. We killed him anyway, of course. He had food. But one of my boys convinced me to check out his story. That's how we found Cutthroat Channel. Once the Deadwood cleared out, it wasn't so hard to keep it clear. Stayed there for years. So the dumb bastard was right. Had to take it first, and that's a thing only mud dogs could do. Tell you the truth, that dumb bastard would have died anyway if he tried heading there on his own. All right, back in the day, whenever a group of folks came traipsing into the mud dog's den, give him a choice. Kill each other or get killed. I told him we was weeding out the weak. But that wasn't the real reason. That particular tradition started the day Chavis and his gang rolled in and said they wanted to join forces. I normally ain't the trusting type, but yeah, there was only three of them, all torn up like they'd try to steal fish from a bear. The rest of Chavis's gang had been chewed up by Deadwood, he said. That seemed legit to me. I was just about to let him join when Chavis's deputy, a woman with the unlikely name Sunny, turns on the other two and starts slicing them up. Well, me and the boys start taking bets. I mean, it was the most fun we'd had in months. After the other two fell, Sunny says Chavis was planning on killing me in my sleep, taking the gang. Ever since, folks come looking to join up. We had them fight each other first. Yeah, it weeds out the weak, yeah. But also make sure nobody's stupid enough to try a coup. Well, I suppose I got one more left in me. I got one. First, let me ask you something. Your family's starving. Has been for days, and there's no food nowhere, except for a bunker where a bunch of survivors are holed up. What do you do? You're thinking like a mud dog. Problem was, there was four of them for every one of us. All of them packing. I said to my dogs, What's the one thing this world's got no end of? More than guns or food or mudders, what got more than enough of both? Deadwood, I said. See, the Root don't care about food or guns. All you gotta do is break a bunker open. The Root'll clean out the nest and leave you the rest. That's the world it was, stranger. Dog eat dog. Because, traveler, I'm reformed. Yeah, true is truth, anyway. And a hell of a lot truer than anything my old man'll tell you. Good. Got tired of it. All right. I'll answer. What else you... Now with... Good choice. Watch your back. Yeah, I know who to trust.
You look like you're ready for anything, Traveler. And make sure you gear up before leaving town, Traveler.
Where are you going? God damn, it is you! The rumors had me thinking I might not ever see you again. Ooh, yikes. Yeah, they said you ran off with that old Ford fella and disappeared, and I ain't seen you since. Where have you been? You mean that big-ass floating gem over there? Bo said it can take you other places, other worlds even. Before we got here, I'd have laughed in his face. But I've heard weirder stories than that. And I can... see on your face, it ain't all make-believe, is it? Feels like anything can be true here. They even healed my root rot. I tell you what, I might just start believing in fairy tales. Even Santa Claus and Fulton's Blend. Yeah, I don't know what's in that stuff Doc Nora gave me, but I ain't felt this good for years. Hell, maybe it was Fulton's Blend. Ah, you know me. I get anxious sitting still for too long. So, I went out to the ruins and scrounged anything useful I could find. I was just doing what I do to survive, you know. Maybe get some things together for when we moved on, but then you didn't come back. And Bo said folks around here could use this stuff, so I set up shop. So hey, if you ever need anything out there in the worlds or whatever, you just let me know. I got all kinds of stuff for trade. Come back if you need anything.
Ain't got nothing to go back to.
What can I do for you?
Go on then.
This town is home now. What you need? See you around, traveler.
Reach your camera. Here they come. Out of room.
Here to waste more of our time.
Fare thee well, Strix. Thank you.
Yeah.
Very well.
Okay, this is it.
You're back.
Tread carefully now, stranger. For Faelor is strict and swift, and you stand to accuse one of its highest ranking members.
If you accuse one of us, you must have evidence, new evidence, to support your claim. The penalty for frivolous accusations against the Council is steep.
It is death, foreigner, at least for you. Swift and immediate.
Are you prepared to make an accusation according to our laws? Then speak. Who among us aided the imposter?
What? Preposterous! I won't ask you for proof of such a frivolous accusation, for there is none you could have.
Motives are not proof, but you have now wrongfully and willfully brought
the law.
I'll say this.
Get up!
Yo, what up?
How's it going? Oh. Oh shit, what the hell? Yo. Oh, okay. Nightmare mode. Oh, this right off the bat, this shit. Oh my god. Okay.
What is this? Not Drazier. Some work of that damn custodian. No, no. Something else. Our sentient thing. We bled ourselves in search of you. Yet here, at the end of all things, you have found us. Amusing. Perhaps you have, and not known. Years of reflection have laid bare miracles in my mind that I never dreamed possible. Yet some things remain out of reach. Tell me, my world, precious Nerud, what has become of it? And yet you commune with me now through the speaker's pulpit. Pray tell me, how did you come by this world? No, 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 do not answer. I see it now, at the edge of my mind. But I dare not know it. You and I share this much in common, then. We are cut off from our people, and we share a similar end. Mine lies in Alepsis Tora, while yours... No. To speak it is to change it. Already it shifts. Rest assured. Our fates bind us together. So I ask a favor, and will offer one in return. On the surface of this world lie several chambers that were shielded, as I was, from the cruelty of Alepsis Tora. These chambers bear the soul sparks of the Drazir, our last remaining legacy. Find them and bring them to me. But not here, not to this contemptible chamber in which you now reside. You must find me in the flesh. My temple can be found within the wastes above. Look for the all-seeing eye of the Astropaths. Bring me the soul sparks, and we will speak further. Ask the... Bring me the soul...
Causes bleed damage?
More bad news. Shit.
Oh, seriously? Ammo. Oh, damn. Oh, appreciate that, bro. It didn't pop up.
This isn't looking good.
Oh shit, okay. Okay.
All right, come and get some.
Ba-ba-ba-ba. Ah, shit.
All right, let's do it.
Oh, yeah. Oh, didn't want to do that. Yes. Sheesh. Did he get rid of my... Let's see. Oh, it did. I thought there was an enemy by me. What you whining for, Dweet?
Unexpected. Nerud spent eons searching for life, yet now of all times you come to Nerud on your own. I have much I wish to know, but there is a more pressing task. I need your help. I believe you may be the against all reason. He opposes what I am trying to do. I cannot act without him, but I must act. I need you to find him, extract his echo, and return it to me. Unfortunately, you will have to dispose of Talratha. There is no one. Unfortunately, I cannot reach him. Only you can. Talratha keeps himself locked within his chamber. This, it is poisoned. Not strong enough to finish the task, but it should weaken him enough to make it easier. He only needs to consume it. I will answer. Seek out Talratha. bring me his echo.
Nope, 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 nope. Not what I wanted to do. I don't want to use it. Okay. Oops.
Great. More bad news.
Hunter Gunslinger?
Happened here.
Oh, yeah. So this should be... Oh, this is the same exact... Okay. Okay. The fuck? Oh, okay. Okay. Ooh, ooh! Can I jump on that? Oh shit. Maybe? Dude, I should try and jump on that. We'll come back. I bet you can. Gotta be able to, right? Oh! Okay, you can jump on it. Now, where do we go to jump off? Hold on. I think I seen it. Gotta be something, right?
Okay.
There's something big out there. Oh yeah, what is this ring doing? After sprinting. Oh, hey. Oh, I fucked up. I really fucked up. Shit. Yo, I can cruise through this now. Maybe it's not in adventure mode.
Here they come.
Yeah, right there, right there, right there. Okay, okay, okay. We gotta hurry and... Okay. Don't roll! Oh, you fuck, bitch. I hate how he rolls. Fucking bitch.
Thank you.
Oh my god, it's the fucking same spot. Jesus. Wait, you can move your character. Oh my god, I didn't know you can move your character in the air while he's falling. That's cool. Dude, I'm gonna make a, I wanna make a melee class. They made melee so much better in this one. Like, it's actually worth making a melee build. Wait, is this one? This one's like great. Come on, we got it. Oh! Woo! Oh!
That's nice.
Yo! Yo! Oh, hell yeah. Ooh, what up, Twitch? Dude, ain't no way. Oh, dude. What up? What? Nice! Hell yeah! Congrats! That's what I'm talking about. That'll be me soon, hopefully. Vision strike? Hold up. Wait. On neutral evade attacks, Atom Splitter achieves nuclear fission, releasing a wave of charged particles, which deals 160.5 damage to targets within 20 meters. Charged neutral evade attacks increase range 3 times and damage. What the fuck? Wait, no, hold on. Oh, hell no. Dude, what the hell did I just find? Fucking right, dude. This game is crazy, man. There's so many different things you can find. Every time you can re-roll the campaign in adventure mode, and every time it's different. You can find new there's so many rings and weapons and items, gear. Classes, there's 5 hidden classes you can find. On top of the other classes you get. Definitely, I was just talking about making a melee build. Oh, what up, boy? I forgot I'm on nightmare mode. Or nightmare difficulty. That's awesome, Twigs.
Alright.
Freaking right. I guess, Season 5, they're adding new stuff to gunfight. Maybe sniper only and knife. Throwing knife. I haven't played in a minute, though. Uh-oh. Electricity gun's glitching out. I think that is... Yeah. Boss time, maybe? Can we kill it? Ah, fuck. What? Yo. Bro, there's no way I'm gonna have to platform this shit. I gotta level this thing up. I have to. Wait, what if I stay in here? And, there's gotta be a secret. Gotta be, right? Wait, hold on. stay in here. It's gonna rotate. Right? Are we gonna... Does that one not rotate again? Oh! It is. Maybe I'm overthinking. Can you get up there? Probably jump down there. I might die though. Oh my god. I lived. What the fuck? Is this what I'm supposed to do? I feel like I just skipped the whole entire area. Shit. Damn, what if there's something up there? Oh, okay, it's just... okay. Oh, wait, maybe I'm supposed to go down here? I'm gonna go back up. Oh, I think I'm supposed to be down there. Gotta wait for this one to rotate. Bitch. How did I die? Excuse me? Dude, I should be leveling up. Hold on. Let's swap this. Hold on. Medic and Challenger. Dude. Yeah. Definitely leveling Challenger up. The melee. Melee build. Alright, now I gotta sit here and wait. Oh my god, I didn't even see you, bro. Oh, for real? Reload. Thank you. the fuck was that? Oh. Ah, with it now, dude. Oh shit, okay. Alright, you're finally rotating this one? Let's go. I just drop down. Yeah, it's not that far.
Here they come.
You're under the fucking platform. This motherfucker. I'm not getting any XP. Okay, let's not do that then. What's happening? Ah, shit. shit. Okay, cocksucker, bitch. Get up. Oh. That was it? Okay. Where's it at? Ooh, evade distance. What? Are you for real? Max those out first. Freaking A, dude, I don't even. Oh, what the piss is this? What? Bro, that's a gun. I'm pretty sure that's a gun. It looks like a gun. What the heck? Alright, now we have to find the key. Shit. Dude, I fucking knew it. I fucking knew it, dude. I knew there's a reason for those spinning. Not just a passage. I waited in the wrong one. Wait, what's the point of this area? Checkpoint, okay. Wait, actually. Wait a minute. Am I stuck here? Oh, fucking hell no. Damn it. I gotta go to the Ward 13, then I gotta teleport back. Ow. Damn it. Dude, there's two weapons in that dungeon. Choir fit. Oh, achievement. What up, Ray? Is it? Nah, I'm just playing Remnant. I'll let you know, Freezy. Wait, what? For real? I could have just went down this way. What the fuck? That's crazy. Oh, my dumbass. I didn't have to wait for that. New handgun. Mid-range pistol shotgun.
I can tell you. Be sure to come back for some stew.
Greetings. Only the bit.
Had me thinking I might not ever see you again.
Oh yeah?
Damn straight. So where? Feels like anything can be true here.
Yeah. Hell, maybe it was Fulton's.
Hey. I'll be here when you get back.
Oh boy, alright. I think I'm gonna be Yo! That's odd. Yeah, I'm gonna end the stream here. I'll be on tomorrow for sure. So, thanks for watching, everybody. Peace!